Welcome to Algebra 2, Lesson 154. So, we have four word problems that we're going to work on. So, I'm going to read them from the book. It says, from a point A on a cliff, it has an angle of depression to a train station at point B is 60 degrees. So, there's the angle of depression. If the distance from the foot of the cliff to the station, which is BC, is 160 yards, find the height of the cliff. So we're trying to find out how tall this cliff is. So since we have a right triangle, we're going to work with right triangles. We know sine, cosine, and tangent. So let's look at this to see which one we have. So from angle B, this would be 60 degrees, because this is 60, and when you have, these are parallel lines, that alternate interior angles are equal, so this is 60 degrees also. So, this would be our B. So, our B is opposite, over, and then we have adjacent. So what uses opposite and adjacent? Well, that would be tangent. So we're going to say the tangent of 60 equals the opposite over the adjacent. So B equals to B over 160. Now, you can put in your calculator tangent 60 or look back on your chart, and we know that was the square root of 3. So square root of 3 equals to B over 160. Well, in order to solve for B, we have to get rid of 160 by multiplying both sides by 160. So 160 square root of 3 equals B. And then you can put that in your calculator and you will get 277.1 yards. So that's how you solve that. Number 5, I'll read that to you. The rope on the top of a flagpole makes an angle of 60 degrees. So here's our flagpole, and the rope makes an angle of 60 degrees with the ground at point, this is 320, sorry, 320. Okay. Find the length of the rope. So we need to find this. So this is our hypotenuse because it's opposite of the 90 degrees. So we know tangent would not be involved because tangent does not have hypotenuse. So from this point A, we have adjacent and we have hypotenuse. So we'll have to do cosine. So the cosine of 60 degrees is equal to adjacent over hypotenuse. It would be 320 over B. Now, in order to solve for that, we would have to multiply both sides by B and then divide by this. So basically what happens is these two spots reverse. So B is equal to 320 over cosine of 60 degrees. Now, you'll have to put that into your calculator, and that would be 640 is equal to B. But we also know that this is 1/2, don't we? So we could also have, instead of this, because when you look back on our chart, the cosine of 60 is 1/2. So we could have also put 1/2 equals 320 over B, and then cross multiply, and B equals 640. So that's a way to do it without a calculator. Okay, now let's do this one. I'm going to go ahead and erase this portion to have room for number 6. So, it has to do with a tree. You like my drawing? So anyways, find the distance from A to T, the top of the tree. If the angle of elevation of the top of the tree is 30 degrees, so elevation going up, so that's why it's 30 there, and A is 67.5 feet from the foot of the tree. So we're going to have to find X. We don't know the distance here. Well, that is our hypotenuse because it's straight across. So we are going to have the cosine again because here we had adjacent over hypotenuse, adjacent over hypotenuse. So the cosine of 30 equals, six, seven, five over x, because it's adjacent over x. Now, on our chart, the cosine of 30 is a half times square root of 3. So we'll set that equal to this. Then we will cross multiply. So this would be x square root of 3 equals this times this. But when we double that, it's 135. Then we have to divide by it to get x by itself. So x equals 135 divided by the square root of 3. And when you put that in the calculator, you get 77.9 feet. So that is that. Now, you have to go to this page, and on the bottom is where these three are, because there's 11 on the top part, but this is the check for progress part. And you can do 11, 12, and 13. Good luck.